Oke, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Ana Rebel Mim Lasmi as the lecturer of this lesson, or I mean TOEFL lesson. Here we are going to explain our material of reading comprehension. And here we are from the SIG group. And there are 4 people, and the first informant is me. My name is Ameliawati, and the second informant is Fitri Cantika, the third is Afifur Rahman, and the last is Bella Rosadina. Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I'm the first informant. I will explain about the reading comprehension questions. Here there are 2 parts. And the first is the reading comprehension section of the TOEFL test consists of 5 reading passages, each followed by a number of reading comprehension and vocabulary questions. Topics of the reading passage are varied, but there are often information subjects that might be studied in a American university. American history, literature, art, architecture, geology, geography, and astronomy. And the second is, time is definitely of a factor in the reading comprehension section. Many students who take the TOEFL test know that there are a number to finish all the questions in this section. Therefore, you need to make the most efficient use of your time in this section to get the highest score. The following method is the best way of attacking a reading passage to get the most question correct in a limited amount of time. That's all from me. Maybe we'll continue from the second informant.
Okay, I will continue. My name is Fitri Cantika Indayani, the second presenter. And I will explain about strategies for the reading comprehension question. 5 strategies for the reading comprehension question. Number 1. Skim the reading passage to determine the main idea and the overall organization of ideas in the passage. You do not need to understand every detail in each passage to answer the question correctly. It is therefore a waste of time to read the passage with the intent of understanding every single detail before you try to answer the question. And then number 2, look ahead at the question to determine what types of question you must answer. Each type of question is answered in a different. And then number 3, find the section of the passage that deals with each question. The question types tells you exactly where to look in the passage to find correct answer. Firstly, for main idea question, look at the first line of each paragraph. The second, for directly and indirectly answered detailed question, choose a keyword in the question and skim for that keyword or a related idea in order in the passage. And the third, for vocabulary question, the question will tell you where the word is located in the passage. And the last, for overall review question, the answers are found anywhere in the passage. And then number 4, read the part of the passage that contains the answer carefully The answer will probably be in the same sentence or one sentence before or after the keyword or idea. And then the last, number 5, choose the best answer to each question. For the 4 answer, choose listen in your textbook. You can choose the best answer according to what is given in the appropriate section of the passage. Eliminate definitely wrong answers and mark your best guess on the answer set.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I am Afifur Rahman as the 3rd presenter. I would like to explain you about vocabulary question. In the reading comprehension section of the TOEFL test, there will be a number of vocabulary question. To answer these types of question, it is of course helpful if you know the meaning of the word that the TOEFL test is testing. However, it's not always necessary for you to know the meaning of the word. Okay, there are 3 skills that you can use to help you find the correct answer to the question. Number 1, finding definition from structural clues. Number 2, determining meanings from word parts. 3, using context clues to determine meanings. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Bella Rosyadina. I'm from 6th group. I will explanation about vocabulary question, how to answer the question. The first is structural clues. When you are asked to determine the meaning of a word in the reading comprehension section of the TOEFL test, it is possible. The first, that the passage provide information about the meaning of the word. The second is that there are structural clues to tell you that the definition of a word is included in the passage. And the example is the question according to first line of the passage, what is a teddy bear? I choose the plaything because to answer the first question, you should look at the part of the passage following the word of teddy bear. The dash punctuation indicates that a definition or further information about teddy bear is a child toy, a nice soft stuffed animal suitable for cuddling. So I choose D, a plaything. The second is use context to determine meaning of difficult word. On the TOEFL test, you will sometimes be asked to determine the meaning of a difficult word, a word that you are not expected to know. In this case, the passage will give you a clear indication of the word means. The example, a line in the passage, the bird heard across the lake. The question is, a bird is probably which of the following? I choose D, a boat, because in this type of question, you are not expected to know the meaning of the word, but instead, you should understand from the context that if the bird went across a lake, then it is probably a type of boat. And the best question is D. The third is use context to determine meaning of simple word. You will sometimes be asked to determine the meaning of a simple word, a word that you see often in everyday English. In this type of question, you should not give the normal, everyday meaning of the word. Instead, the tool test wants to know the meaning of the word in this situation. Example, a line from the passage. He put his answer this way. The question is, the word put is closest in meaning to which of the following? I choose A, placed. In this type of question, you should understand that put is a normal, everyday word, and you are not being asked to give the regular meaning of a normal, everyday word, because the primary meaning of to put is to place. The good answer is A, place. And how to answer all of the question? The first is find the word in the passage. The second is read the sentence that contains the word carefully. The third is look for context clues to help you understand the meaning. And the last is choose the answer that the context indicate. Okay, that's all for me. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, that's all from us. We say sorry of our mistake and thank you to the listener. We hope you get what we given of our material.